Good morning, children. In the last class, we read about the states of Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. Today, we will read about Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. These two states also lie on the eastern coastal plains, and they are the last states that are on eastern coastal plains. So, let us first read about Tamil Nadu. It is the southernmost state of India, located to the south of Andhra Pradesh. Capital is Chennai. Rivers are Kaveri, Palar and Vaigai. Language is Tamil and English. So children, Tamil Nadu is a state that lies on the southernmost part of India. Southernmost means towards the southmost part of India, and it lies below or to the south of Andhra Pradesh. See here children, on the very end you will see the portion which is shaded in green color, that is Tamil Nadu. On top you have Andhra Pradesh, and just beside Tamil Nadu you have Kerala. So this is the exact location of Tamil Nadu, and you can also see Chennai. So that is the capital of Tamil Nadu. Chennai is the capital of Tamil Nadu. And children, the rivers which flow in Tamil Nadu are Kaveri, Palar and Vaigai. These three are the rivers flowing here. And languages spoken by people are Tamil and English. So mostly Tamil and English are only spoken by the people living here. Then we will read about traditional dress. Men wear dhoti or vesti with shirt. Women wear saris. Dance. Bharatanatyam is a well-known classical dance form of the state. Festivals are Pongal, Eid, Diwali and Christmas are celebrated in Tamil Nadu. So children, traditional dress of Tamil Nadu shows its rich culture. So Tamil Nadu is blessed with rich culture. And here people mostly like to wear cotton and silk clothes. So men wear dhoti, and dhoti is popularly known as vesti in Tamil Nadu. So dhoti has a specific name in Tamil Nadu, and it is known as vesti. And they wear a shirt along with vesti. So they wear vesti and shirt. Now the women, they mostly wear saris. Now, Bharatanatyam is Tamil Nadu's classical dance, and it is performed mostly by the women. And children, Bharatanatyam is the oldest dance form which is performed in India. So, Tamil Nadu is one of the oldest dance forms of India. Now, we will come to festivals. So Tamil Nadu, children, is a land of diverse culture. So the people belonging to different religions are living in Tamil Nadu, and they celebrate many festivals, like they celebrate Pongal, Eid, Diwali and Christmas. So all these festivals are the main festivals which are celebrated in Tamil Nadu. Now we will read about occupation. Farming is the main occupation of the state. Tea, coffee, rice, cotton, sugarcane and groundnut are the main crops of the state. Textiles, heavy machinery, handlooms, electronics and automobiles are the major industries of the state. So children, in Tamil Nadu, people are mostly involved in farming. So they are involved in farming, and they grow tea, coffee, rice, cotton, sugarcane and groundnut. So these are some of the major crops which are grown by the people of Tamil Nadu. Then the industries in Tamil Nadu are textile industry, heavy machinery. Heavy machinery means big and heavy machine parts are made here. Then you have handloom industry, electronics industry and automobile industry. So these are some industries which are found in Tamil Nadu. Next is tourism. Marina Beach, Mahabalipuram, Kanyakumari and the temple towns are popular tourist spots. Chennai and Ennore are the important port cities. Lastly, important cities are Madurai, Kanchipuram and Coimbatore. So children, there are many tourist spots in Tamil Nadu. Like you have the Marina Beach, which is a very beautiful beach. You have Mahabalipuram, Kanyakumari, and there are many temple towns. Towns which have beautiful temples are known as temple towns. So you have many temples also in this state where people come to visit. Then Chennai and Ennore are the port cities. What are port cities? Port cities means cities that have ports. And like we have already discussed, ports are the place where the ships load and unload passengers as well as goods. So, Ennore and Chennai are the port cities of Tamil Nadu. And lastly, the important cities are Madurai, Kanchipuram and Coimbatore. These are the important cities of the state. So, this was it about Tamil Nadu. Now, we will read about Puducherry. So, children, Puducherry is a union territory and it is divided into four districts for administrative purposes. Namely, Puducherry, Karaikal, Mahe and Yanam. So children, if you will see here, in Tamil Nadu only, a very small place is there in purple color and you will see Puducherry is written over there. So that small place is only Puducherry. It is very carefully, if you look, you will see a very small purple color is there inside Tamil Nadu only. That is the exact location of Puducherry. So children, Puducherry is divided into four districts for administrative purposes. Firstly, what is the meaning of Union Territory? Union Territory means that this place comes under the control of central government. Central government takes care of this place. This place is not under the control of state government. So there is no chief minister over here. This place is controlled by the central government. Now, for better administrative purposes, Puducherry is divided into four districts. Four districts is Puducherry, Karaikal, Mahe and Yanam. What do you mean by administrative purposes? Administrative purposes means for handling the place in a better way. For better maintenance of this place, it is divided into four districts, Puducherry, Karaikal, Mahe and Yanam. Now, Puducherry was formerly a French colony till 1954. Puducherry is a multicultural city and an educational hub. So children, Puducherry was formerly means earlier. So earlier Puducherry was a French colony till 1954, means it was under the French rule. It was ruled by French people for a very long time. But the Indian government took it under its control in the year 1954. So now Puducherry is controlled by Indian government only. And Puducherry, children, is a multicultural city. Multicultural means a city where people from different cultures, different religions, different traditions come together and they live in one place. So Puducherry is a multicultural city. And it provides excellent education facilities. So it is a very good city for getting education also. Now, majority of people speak Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, French and English. As you can see, Telugu, Malayalam, French and English. So people here speak many languages. Like you have Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, French and English. all these languages are spoken by different people of Puducherry. Now, what are the industries here? The industries here manufactures computer, electronics, rice bran oil, pharmaceuticals, leather goods, and many other products. So here there are many industries which manufactures computers also, which makes electronic products, which makes rice bran oil. Rice bran oil is a kind of refined oil which we use for cooking. Then you have pharmaceuticals. Pharmaceutical is a company that makes medicines. You have leather goods. All the different types of leather bags, shoes, belts are made here. So these are some of the products which are made in Puducherry. Lastly, there are beautiful beaches in Puducherry, and the Aurobindo Ashram is an attraction for tourists from all over the world. So Puducherry is a very beautiful place and it has some very beautiful beaches, children. Next, Aurobindo Ashram is also a major tourist spot where people from all over the world come to visit this place. So today, children, we read about Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. These two states lie on the eastern coastal plain of India. And in the next class, we will read about two island groups of India, that is the Lakshadweep and the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So children, you will read the portion that is taught today. And if you have any doubts, you are free to message me on Campus Care. Now this was it for today, children. I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.